Hi everyone, so welcome to another lecture video. So I know it has been more than a month since my last video. I was little ill, so now we'll start our lecture series or continue our lecture series. Okay, so today we will learn about the suture patterns. You see, suture patterns is basically a practical class. Okay, but there are some theory portions to this suture pattern, so you should know beforehand, so that when after this video I will go for a demonstration video on different suture techniques. So when you will be seeing the suture techniques, you can relate the theory portion. Okay, so that we can understand or visualize or imagine in a better way. So first, the suture patterns. You see, the suture patterns is basically divided into two parts or two types: the interrupted pattern and the continuous pattern. You see, you will find in many books there are different types of classification, like classification of matter suture, classification of different continuous sutures also. But in a broad term, you can remember it as an interrupted pattern suture and the continuous pattern suture. Okay, first of all, the interrupted pattern sutures, which techniques are the interrupted patterns? The simple interrupted, the cruciate, the mattress. You see, mattress is of two types: the horizontal and the vertical. Okay, the Halsted. Halsted is nothing but the interrupted lumbar suture. It's known as Halsted. Okay, this can come as an objective question. Next, this is Gambi pattern. You see, this comes as an objective question even in entrance examinations also. Okay, the Gambi sutures technique used for intestine surgery. I'll go for each individual sutures, their advantage, their disadvantage, everything I will cover that. But remember, here the Gambi pattern is used for intestinal surgery. Okay, this comes as an objective question, the Gambi pattern. Like the continuous pattern sutures, simple continuous, four interlocking or simply interlocking suture. Next, Lombard. You see, Lombard, there is also Jobert. Okay, what is the difference between Lombard and Jobert? I will tell when I'll go for the Lombard only. Next, Cossing, there is also a Connell. Okay. Next, you see, tendon suturing is a separate chapter or separate part of this suture pattern. Okay, now remember the names, I will demonstrate in a separate video. Okay, the Kessler's, you see, Kessler's has different variation, like modified Kessler's have different variations. Next, Bonnell, three loop pulley, and this is far, near, near, far. Okay, FNNF, the far, near, near, far suture for tendon repair. Okay, these four are main types of tendon repair suture. Sometimes they use, they are being used with combination. Okay, sometimes they use double Kessler's, or they will use the far, near, near, far and the Kessler. Okay, so to strengthen the tendons. Okay, so these four are basically the tendon suturing. I will deal with this tendon suturing in a separate demonstration video. Okay, so you can comment. I am thinking to start a practical series on practical surgery series. Okay, so that I will go for the different instrumentations, different instrument and they are used, different suture materials, so that I can purchase from market different sutures, how they look, what is the braided sutures, what are the monofilament sutures. Okay, I am thinking to start. If you think this will be helpful, please comment down below. Okay, now we will go for the individual sutures. So now coming to the sutures, individual sutures, first we will see the interrupted pattern sutures. Okay, so first the simple interrupted suture pattern. Okay, we will discuss the advantage, disadvantage and where they being used. So first, the suture interrupted, the simple interrupted suture pattern, they are basically used for skin. Okay, linea alba closure. You can comment down below what is linea alba. Okay, linea alba for small incision. Okay, for elective OHE like that operation, you can use the simple interrupted for closing the abdomen, but I won't recommend using simple interrupted for closure of linea alba. Also, you can use for intestinal closures or a teratomy or enterography. Okay, so this simple interrupted can be used in these surgeries. Mostly they are being used in skin closure. Okay, so what are the advantages of simple interrupted sutures? They are very easy and quick to place. Okay, and you see the apposition is maximum. Okay. Next, the suture line fail, the chances of suture line failure will be very less, because you see this is the incision line. The simple interrupted like will be look like this. Okay. Suppose, imagine if one suture by chance, by any means, the one suture is disrupted. Okay, so it won't affect the whole suture line. Okay, the suture line failure chances are very minimal in simple interrupted pattern of suture. Next, the disadvantages are, as there are many sutures to be placed, so it takes more time comparing to the other suture techniques. Okay, so it takes really more time. Okay, next. As you can see, there will be more foreign materials. Okay, there will be number of sutures you will be placing to for closure of the skins or any organ which you are closing by simple interrupted pattern. You will find more of foreign materials. You see, these comparisons are basically with each other. Okay, so it doesn't mean that here there will be more foreign material or any suture there will be less foreign material. Okay, comparing to the you can compare with the cruciate, you will find more foreign material in simple interrupted pattern of suture. Next, the cruciate is same as of the simple interrupted. You can use for skin closure of linea alba, but it is not used in intestinal closures. Okay, so the cruciate pattern is a appositional suture. You see, you can also classify the sutures according to the apposition. Okay, whether the appositional or there will be eversion. Okay, but they are old concept, remember, as the continuous pattern and the interrupted pattern. This is a appositional suture, and comparing to the simple interrupted, there will be less foreign material, less suture used. Next, the mattress pattern, the horizontal and the vertical mattress. You see, horizontal mattress and vertical mattress, they are basically used in areas of tension. Okay, where you will find more tension, use these two, the horizontal or vertical mattress pattern. Okay, they are tension relieving sutures. Okay, first, the horizontal mattress, it is very rapid. You see, if you will compare the horizontal mattress and the simple interrupted, the time taken for horizontal mattress is nearly half for the simple interrupted. Okay, if suppose you take 15 minutes for a closure of this length, so incision for in simple interrupted will take 15 minutes, whereas in horizontal matter it may take 7 minutes or 6 minutes, like that. Okay, it is very fast. Okay, very rapid. The disadvantage being, there will be tissue eversion. Okay, you will find a elevated structure. Okay, suppose you have given incision here. Okay, this is a basically the lateral view. Okay, after suturing it will be like this. Okay, there will be tissue eversion. Here will be suture. Okay, this is tissue eversion. Okay, in both the mattress pattern, the horizontal and vertical, they are basically eversion sutures. You will find the tissue eversion. This is a disadvantage of the horizontal mattress. Next, the wound dehiscence. You see, wound dehiscence is more profound or more pronounced in horizontal mattress rather than the vertical mattress. Why? So you see, this is a incision line. How horizontal mattress will look like? Okay, this is how the horizontal mattress looks. Okay, you see, this is the suture material. The blood vessels usually supply the skin like this. Okay, so when you will place suture here, it will block these blood vessels or the capillary supplying to this area. See, this area. So when there will be less blood supply, what will happen? Okay, there will be dehiscence. That is why the wound dehiscence is more in case of horizontal mattress. Remember, to avoid the wound dehiscence in case of horizontal mattress, while you are placing the horizontal mattress sutures, don't make it too tight. Okay, when you will make it too tight, the suture dehiscence, the incidence of suture dehiscence also increases. So remember this, to place the sutures little loose while placing the horizontal mattress sutures. Otherwise, you can go for the vertical mattress pattern. Okay, it is also applied in areas of tension. Okay, it is basically more stronger than the horizontal mattress, and you will find less wound adhesions, because in horizontal mattress the sutures will be placed like this. Okay, it will look like this. It is usually parallel to the blood supply, so there won't be any blockage to the capillary or blood supply. That is why vertical mattress has less wound adhesions cases. But thing is, it is more time consuming than the horizontal mattress. Okay, so as a surgeon, you will decide, or according to your experience, you will decide which suture materials or which suture patterns to be placed. Next, Holstead. You see, Holstead is not being used nowadays. Okay, because they don't produce the exact apposition. Okay, this is the disadvantage of Holstead. Holstead is nothing but interrupted lumbar. Okay, so this is not used. Now, the Gamby. I already told you, Gamby is used for intestinal surgery. Okay, you see, intestine has four distinct layers. First one, from outside to inside, is serosa. Then the muscularis, the submucosa, and the mucosa. Okay, so this is four layers. So this is intestine. I am depicting the layers in a single line. Okay, see, this is the intestine. When you will do enterotomy, okay, you will give an incision. Okay, usually what happens, the mucosa will inverted out. Okay, you will find the mucosa to be inverted out. Here there will be mucosa. Okay, the mucosa will come out. Okay, so to reduce this mucosal eversion, we use the Gamby pattern. Okay, this is the advantage of Gamby pattern. It is reduces the mucosal eversion. Okay, now you comment down below why there will be mucosal eversion in intestinal surgery. Why there will be mucosal eversion? You see, it is the hint is related to the anatomy of mucosa. Okay, due to the anatomy of mucosa, they usually evert, there will be mucosal eversion. Okay, so still you have to answer or comment down below why there will be mucosal eversion. Okay, remember, the hint is the mucosa, anatomy of the mucosa. Okay, so this is the Gamby pattern. The disadvantage of Gamby pattern is basically time consuming. It takes much more time than the usually the intestinal enterography is done by the Cushing pattern. Okay, it takes more time than the Cushing pattern. Okay, time consuming. Now this is all about the interrupted pattern sutures. Now we will go for the continuous pattern sutures. So now coming to the continuous pattern sutures. Okay, the first one is the simple continuous. Okay, they are basically used for linear alba closure, very common. Also the subcut sutures to closing the subcutaneous spaces, the simple continuous pattern is being used. The advantage being the maximum tissue apposition. Okay, if you will compare the all these sutures for a closure of skin, the simple continuous will have the maximum apposition. Even if for linear alba while closing, there will be maximum tissue apposition. You see, better the tissue apposition, better will be healing. Okay, next, the disadvantage being the suture security. You see, the simple continuous will look like this. Okay, like this. Suppose there is a suture dehiscence or damage to the suture material here. Okay, the entire suture line will fail. That is why the suture security is minimum or very very less in case of the simple continuous pattern of suture, and this is why they are being used internally, okay, for closure of linear alba or the subcutaneous sutures. Okay, because if you use in skin, suppose the animal disrupts one suture here, then the entire suture line will fail. Next, the interlocking is slightly better version of the simple continuous suture. Okay, but the thing is there will be more foreign material, okay, and it is very difficult to remove. Sometimes they will get tangled. Okay, that is why the interlocking has disadvantage of difficult to remove. Okay. Next, the Lombard. You see, Lombard and Cushing, these both are the inversion sutures. You see, mattress is a eversion suture, while as the Lombard and Cushing, they are inversion sutures. They are basically used for suturing the internal organs. Okay, most of the internal organs, they will be closed by Lombard or the Cushing. The difference between the Lombard and Cushing is only the whether they are parallel or vertical to the suture line. Lombard is vertical to the suture line while placing the Lombard suture, while as the Cushing is horizontal or parallel. Okay, you see in mattress also the vertical mattress and the horizontal mattress, while similarly in inversion suture, Lombard and Cushing. You see, there is also a Jobot. Lombard, Jobot, you will be remembering, like Lombard, Jobot, Cushing and Cornell. What is the difference between these? You see, the intestine has four layers. I already told you, the serosa, the muscularis, the submucosa and the mucosa. Okay, so in Lombard and Cushing, okay, the suture material or the needle will not penetrate the mucosa. It will go up to the submucosa and it will come up. These are basically Lombard and Cushing. While in case of Jobot and Cornell, it will go through the mucosa. Okay, it means in case of Lombard and Cushing, the suture won't go to the lumen. While in case of Jobot and Cornell, you will find the suture materials in the lumen. Okay, and this is also the disadvantage of Jobot and Cornell. You see, suppose you are doing a surgery of bladder. Okay, and there is a suture material inside the lumen. You see, by coming in contact to the urine, they may lose their strength beforehand. Okay, this may there will be chance of leakage. Okay, that is why always prefer Lombard or Cushing material type of suture pattern while the closing the internal organs. Okay, especially the hollow organs. Now the Lombard, the disadvantage of Lombard is it is not watertight. That is why it is not used in case of bladder surgery. Even if intestinal surgery, they mostly use the Cushing pattern. Next, the sutures are visible in case of Lombard pattern. You see, when I will demonstrate the Lombard and Cushing, you can clearly or you can appreciate this suture visibility. I will do that later. Next, the Cushing is watertight and the sutures will not be visible. Okay, I always prefer the Cushing over Lombard. Lombard you can use in rumenotomy also. Okay. In case of rumenotomy, I usually prefer Lombard, but Cushing is always better than Lombard. Next, the Parker care. You see, Parker care, this suture, okay, it is not used nowadays, but there will be some. In my Viva, they asked me the Parker care, okay, in surgery Viva. The Parker care is basically the combination of Cushing and Lombard. They are usually used for closing the stump of uterus. Okay, so in case of pyometra, you will remove whole ovary and uterus, there will be some part of uterine body, there will be uterine body will be left. So for closing the uterine the body, you will use the both coxing and lumbar, which is known as the Parker care. Okay, so this is all about the continuous pattern sutures. Okay, so here we finish the suture techniques. All of them will be demonstrated by me in a separate video. Okay, you don't need to worry. So I may start in the practical surgery series. Okay, so that I can go for the suture techniques, different instruments, their use, and also how to arrange the instrument in instrument table. Okay, all of those will be covered, but I need your comments. Okay, if you want this, you can comment down below so that we can start this series. Okay, and I hope that the video will come now regularly. Okay, so this is all about the sutures. Next class we will go for the wounds, that is another important class. Okay, don't miss that class. Okay, so see you, tata, bye bye, and stay home, stay safe. Okay, corona is dangerous.